Hey everyone, it's Chili Gong. Welcome to my channel. The PSG tournament in Brawl Stars is right around the corner where you can win a sweet PSG Dynamite skin. And Brawl Ball is my favorite mode in Brawl Stars, so I wanted to make a video about my most important tip when playing Brawl Ball that hopefully will improve your gameplay and help you win. First, here are a couple of general notes. Letting go of the ball, whether by passing or by shooting, requires one ammo. To pass or shoot the ball extra far and extra quickly, if your super is charged and you are holding the ball, you can use your super to shoot the ball. This can easily cover almost 50% of the map, which is especially important in overtime. With that said, the most important tip I think will help people in winning Brawl Ball is to pass the ball. That's it. Simple as that. Pass the ball. However, although it seems simple, there's actually a lot of depth to this, as it affects the flow of the game and the area of the map that needs to be controlled as the ball moves around. Passing is a very important skill in Brawl Ball. Just like in real football or soccer, it is helpful in setting up a goal, assist, or moving the ball forward more quickly. Passing the ball is faster than walking with the ball. So if you have a teammate who has a clear shot at the goal, it is faster to pass to them and let them shoot, rather than walking yourself to the net, where you can either be taken down along the way or have the enemy team respawn at the goal and block your shot. Too often have I seen or been in the position where the ball could have been passed and a goal scored, but people hold onto the ball and then it's too late. The net is defended. Another consideration when passing the ball is to try and avoid passing the ball backwards. I have often seen teammates who want to attack an enemy pass the ball backwards to their teammates so that they effectively retain possession of the ball with their team. However, this can be problematic for two reasons. First, it is harder to defend the ball when it is in your zone near your goal. The enemy chances of succeeding are much higher because there is less distance for them to cover when they have the ball. Your team's chances are lower in succeeding because you are now farther from the goal and there is less space for you to maneuver, to dodge attacks, and regain control. Second, by passing the ball backwards, you consume an ammo, so now you are one ammo short to fight the enemy you have chosen to fight in front of you. Once your teammate has picked up the ball behind you, they also cannot effectively attack the enemy because they are now holding the ball. You have now created a situation where you are 1v3, as you have effectively blocked two players on your own side, yourself included, from attacking to the fullest potential. In other words, instead of passing the ball backwards, try and pass forwards, sideways, or diagonal, whichever direction. Just try and avoid backwards. Of course, there's always exceptions to this rule, but you will generally fare better by passing forward. When passing forward, it then becomes a decision of where to send the ball to. Sometimes it can be a self-pass, such as with Daryl, Edgar, Mortis, or Primo. Sometimes you can pass the ball to an enemy brawler if they are about to get in your face and you want to prevent them from attacking you, or at least make them consume an ammo so they can attack fewer times. Sometimes you want to place the ball in an area that the enemy cannot reach well, or at least have to place themselves in a situation where they can be hit by you and your teammates and taken down. Oftentimes, this can be behind a wall. Other times, as I mentioned before, you can pass the ball to your teammate if they have positioned themselves ahead, so that they can sneak a goal in or move the ball even further to continue pressuring the other team. And those are my thoughts about the most important tip for Brawl Ball in Brawl Stars. Pass the ball. Of course, map and brawler composition are also extremely important, and you can find a lot of different tutorials on that from other players, such as SpenLC, Tom, Kairos Time. But the great thing about Brawl Ball is that you can technically win or score in a game without even hitting or killing anyone. Sometimes you can simply outmaneuver or outpressure your opponent to score. And that is part of the thrill and fun in this mode. With that, thanks so much for watching this video. Feel free to give it a like and to subscribe to my channel for more Brawl Stars content. I would really appreciate it. I also stream most Sundays on Twitch at 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so check it out for some good fun. Take care, good luck in the PSG challenge, and most of all, have fun. See you in Brawl Stars. Nice!